70s, I think.
I'd have to say the 50s. 20s.
I love the 40s and 50s because it's a very classic look. You've got some great icons in there, like Elizabeth Taylor and Marilyn Monroe, and they always have this very classic bombshell hair.
To live in a decade or to visit, maybe 60s.
It's probably the 50s, just because women dressed very well, in a feminine way, and they knew how to dress, and fashion was about fashion and looking glamorous, not just to dress.
Hi, I'm Maneva.
And I'm Catherine.
And we're going to explore the world of vintage fashion, and we're going to be talking to some of the people involved in the community.
Is it just fancy dress, or for some people is it more?
After Catherine had a short-lasting romance with Mr. Chaplin,
and Maneva had stopped trying vintage clothes on and being so vain, we went to meet the Tootsie Rollers, a vintage girl group based in London.
Hi, I'm Meg, the peach.
I'm Anna, the sweetheart.
I'm Lisa, the diva.
I'm Kylie, the siren.
And I'm Katie, the puppet.
It's funny because we started out very much with the music. That's where it came from first, wasn't it? And then we were surprised by how many people were interested in what we were wearing.
Even on, you know, more mainstream artists, they have vintage influences, I would say, over the last 5 years, and it's on the rise, I think.
So, why do people like vintage fashion?
Is it because they want to express their individuality?
Or is it a form of escapism at times when things were much simpler?
Or is it just a bit of fun?
The idea that you can actually step back in time to a time when actually you didn't have the same type of stress, when people were 10 times more glamorous, when gentlemen behaved like gentlemen and ladies behaved like ladies. I think that that's one of the biggest draws.
When I dress up in those different periods in vintage clothing, I feel that I'm sort of as a tribute to the time.
By being unique, by wearing something that probably no one else on the street will have, no matter where they go, is something that helps them to be individualistic.
So after speaking to people who know what they are talking about, it confirmed some of the reasons why the vintage community exists and why the trend is growing. But when it comes to clothes, how authentic do you have to be?
If you want to create an authentic look from a period, you should stick to the authentic methods and the authentic tools that we use. But I think if you want to wear vintage style on a day-to-day basis, I think it's good to incorporate your own flair and your own twist in there, so that you're not just copying something of the past, you're bringing your own touch and self-expression into it.
We kind of reinvent the vintage classics with a modern, more wearable twist.
I don't mind a mix and match as long as it's, you know, you got your own slant on it, basically.
This helped us as we were on the guest list for the Blitz party, which has a strict dress code. Thankfully, Lee from Radio Days suggested some 40s dresses we might like to try.
For a 1940s dress, this is a two-piece 40s striped one there, but then you've got something like this, which is a typical American 1940s ladies skirt suit.
Now all we need to do is get our hair and makeup done by the lovely Courtney Bess Green.
I'm creating a really big sort of wave coming and a little bit of a peekaboo bang coming in through here.
You look gorgeous, you look like Dorothy.
Vintage.
atmosphere at the Blitz Party was great. It was authentic, fun and friendly.
Which we think reflects the community as a whole.
Just another way of bringing people together.
I love the clothes, community and the people in it.
I love it too, but personally I'll be sticking to my jeans.